guys, welcome back. If this is your first time happening on my video or seeing my face, welcome. If you are returning, you guys know you are truly appreciated and I thank you. So today's video is all for the oud lovers. Whether you want to start into oud or you're deep into oud, this video is definitely for you. We have some light, sweet, sexy, skinky barnyard oud. And if you fall in any one of those categories or you want to see which oud you should try, definitely stick around. We know that oud or agarwood is one of those popular and expensive scents. Oud's sweet woodsy scent is very, very recognizable. You might barely get a little hint of it, or you might get a whole lot of it, depending on the type of oud that is used. So let's get into these fragrances that I do have to share with you. I'm not going to go too deep in because it might make the video a little too long, and we're not looking for that. Comment down below and tell me which is your favorite oud that you wear in the summer. These fragrances that I'm about to show you can either wear in the daytime or nighttime. Totally up to you. Definitely, we're going to start with Cartier Oud and Santal. We all know how good this is. If you've watched my video for a while now, you already know how I feel about this baby. Oud and Santal is silky, it's creamy, it's sexy. This oud in here is a sweet oud. It lasts, it projects, guys. This is beautiful, beautiful. I move on. Sticking to the same house. Next, we have Cartier Oud Radu. Radu, I think that's the name. Anyway, this, oh God, smelling it. I swear this is more things up in here. This is your not a sweet, sexy oud. This one here is of Sichuan pepper. It's of my favorite note, ginger and oud, guys. This here, when I first got it, if you watch my video before, you know, I just spread a little on my hand. I was like, it wasn't giving me what I was expecting. Then I give it another try and spray myself completely because, hey, hashtag oversprayer. I was like, oh, damn, guys. It moved. The ginger in here is fresh. The Sichuan pepper give it that nice spiciness. And then there's a sweetness to it, guys. This scent, you would not really know that there's oud up in here, but it's beautiful nonetheless. We have Jasmine Oud by Habibi. Oh my gosh, guys, this is warm spice. This is fruity. This is sweet and sexy. And if you're a jasmine lover, even better. Then there is oud. There's a little hint of leather. There's musk, sweet and powdery on tonka bean, guys. Amazing. Next, we're going to move to Fragrance Du Bois Oud Rose Intense. This, guys, it is sweet. It is airy. It's fresh. It's rose, fruity. Guys, I forgot how good this smell. I wore it, I think it's like a week ago. And when I sprayed, I was like, oh my gosh, because usually I'm always spraying Oud Juan Intense. But then I decided to spray this one. I was like, damn, I forget how good Oud Rose Intense is also. Moving on. Sticking to the same house, I'm definitely going to come with Oud Juan Intense from Fragrance Du Bois. You know what this is. This is tropical. This is sexy. This is sparkly pineapple, juicy pineapple, guys. This is so fresh and nice. It is lasting, it's projecting, and it does what you want your fragrance to do. Definitely, definitely, we have to bring Passion de l'Amour from House of Sillage. Guys, you know this is exotic. This is tropical. This is sweet. This is oud, but you won't really know that there's oud if you're not familiar with oud. You won't really know that there's oud in here. You have that fruitiness of raspberry. Then there's saffron. So for me, this I would say is beginner's oud. This and Fragrance du Bois. For me, I would say even oud and santal, that's beginner's oud, because you won't know that there's oud in there. Those are the beginner's sexy oud. Not a beautiful, I would say a beginner's oud also is Penhaligon Bewitching Yasmin. Guys, this is so good. When you smell, there's coffee. When you smell it, you do get a little coffee. Also, you get a little minty licorice scent. It's sweet. There's incense. Oh my gosh, there's so much in here, guys. It's beautiful. And this, she's a little boss baby. Sorry. It actually went straight to my nose. But this right here, see her face? Mean looking, she don't play. She's not playing. Another beautiful oud fragrance that you won't really know is Ardent. This, guys, this is sweet. It has rose inside, beeswax. This is a beautiful scent from House from Boadicea the Victorious. And even though this is on the cheapest verse end, to me, it's better than a lot of their more expensive ones. And I always say that if you watch my video. But this can wear day or this can wear night, guys. Moving to a little tougher one. Love Don't Be Shy Special Blend Limited Edition 2019 Rose and Oud. Guys, this fragrance here is a love-hate fragrance for me. But I love it. At the same time, I don't really like it. If you know what I mean. Apparently they say this is called the Wood of Gods. And I could definitely see that, because why? This, the side that I don't like is the woodsy side, guys. It is so woody. And the side that I do like is the rose. There's marshmallow. So it's like, oh God, let this woodiness pass. But listen, this is a beast. It's a boss. It lasts, it projects, guys. And there's a sweetness that I do like. The only part, as I said, is the woodsy part. And I'm going to show a bottle, actually, that way you guys can see, because this is a decant. So definitely, definitely a boss. Now for the Skanky Barnyard Oud. But when you pass that, it's beautiful, guys. Oud Isfahan. This fragrance here. Oh God, when you pass that little smell that is not too good, the Barnyard Skanky one, you left with a beautiful rose fragrance, guys. This is amazing. You just have to pass that portion first. So I find this more good at evening or nighttime to wear. So see, it's still full. Because this is not a fragrance that you use constantly. This is for one of those. Yeah. By Dior. Another good one we have that is sweet, fruity, is Haramain Amber Oud Gold Edition. Guys, this is beautiful. This is airy. It's aquatic. The melon, it's fruity. The melon. Okay, smell it. The melon in here stands out. You can smell that. Smell it like this. I can get the melon. This is beautiful. This is daytime wear or nighttime wear. But these are perfect for summer. Not a beautiful, sweet, spicy, airy scent is Amarad Oud Tabak. This, guys, is another good scent. When you smell this, you get that spice. It's warm, spicy. Yes. Guess what's inside also? There's ginger, guys. It's fresh. It's airy. It's, you have saffron, you have ginger, you have oud, you have that tobacco in there, guys. This, better tell you whether you want to wear day or evening. I think I mostly have worn this in the evening. And it did amazing, guys. Last but not least is Roja Qatar. And this for me is a semi-sweet. It's more on the dry side. There's fruity notes that when, in the beginning, when you first spray this, you get the citrusness. There's citrus in the top note. Then in the middle note, you get fruits. You get I think you get cotton candy. I don't get the cotton candy. But it do stay on your skin. I can't remember. I think I had gotten at least 6 to 8 hours. I can't remember. It's been a while since I've used this. But because since it's more on the drier side for me, what I do, anytime I wear it, I mix it with a sweet smelling fragrance. Because I like a little more sweet dipping. I'm not too fond of dry scent. So for me, I put some more sweetness up in here and it's perfect. So that was my video of oud. If you are an oud lover, comment down below which is your favorite oud and which oud do you like of the ones that I did show. So let's start a conversation about oud, or if you're not familiar with oud. So thank you guys so much, and stay safe, be blessed, smell good.